Hi there, my name is Lian Duan, and I have developed for over 20 years, specializing in DevOps and cloud security. In this video, I'll show you how to simplify and clarify a GitLab pipeline file using workflow to make it easy to maintain. By the end of this video, you will have a clear understanding of GitLab CI/CD workflow concept, workflow syntax, the workflow first match rule, and how to add workflow into your project. You can find all markdown and pipeline files on my GitLab page. The link is below for you. Let's start by talking about GitLab CI/CD workflow. GitLab CI/CD workflow allows you to control when the pipelines are created and executed. By using the workflow keyword, you can set up rules that define when your pipelines should be run. This makes your pipeline process more efficient and manageable. Now let's move to the workflow syntax. The workflow syntax has two key parts, if and when. If, this condition determines whether the rules should be applied. It can be any valid YAML expression that evaluates to true or false. You can use GitLab variables, customer variables, or logic expression. For example, set commit branch equal to main checks if the branch is main branch. When, this specifies when the rule should be applied and can have values like onSuccess, onFailure, always, manual, allow failure, which determines whether a job is allowed to failure without affect the pipeline status. Also, we can add variables part of the rule. OnSuccess is default value. We don't need to write it down. Before we make a change to our demo pipeline, let's understand the existing pipeline first. In summary, we have rules added to each job, designed to build and test stage jobs run. When branch matched to a pattern, release -v-number or feature branch plus Jira plus number or main branch, enable manual deployment to QA environment. Job name is deploy underline QA. For release and feature branches, while allowing for potential failure, enable manual deployment to the staging environment. For release and feature branches, while allowing for potential failure, automatically deploy to the production environment for main branch only. This configuration enables adaptable to different branch types and controlled deployment to various environments to make your CI/CD process efficient and reliable. You can get the demo pipeline file right here. Now, let's move on to the evaluation sequence and the first matching rule in workflow. Workflow rules in GitLab are evaluated from top to bottom, and the first matching rule is applied. If we copy the job rule to the workflow rule, it's incorrect. For example, we are in main branch. The GitLab go to the line 8 and find the match condition CI commit branch equal to main branch and config two variables. The GitLab stop the evaluate condition in line 13 and 17. That caused main branch does not have any job in deploy stage. To fix the issue, like the main branch do not have any jobs in deployment stage, we should remove work condition from main release feature branch condition and add specific variables under each condition. These variables will be used by restructor demo pipeline. In the restructuring process, we add variables to each job's rule, such as controlling build and test job, use runOutBuild variable. We can use a code comparison tool like WinMerge to quickly check the changes. You see the job rule more clear than before. And we centralize the controlling in workflow code block, and then add variables to each job rules. Back to my markdown file. By the way, you can find the new pipeline file which one has a workflow code block and relate to the change, right here. Now let's test the workflow rules in different branches. Current branch is a feature branch. Let me commit and push. Push. Switch to the release branch and check in. Later, switch to the main branch and push. Switch to the GitLab page. In feature branch, we are able to manually deploy to QE environment. That's right behavior. How about the release branch? Let's check it. In release branch, we are able to manually deploy to QA and staging environment, the same as before. That's our expectation. How about main branch? Let me open it. In main branch, we are able to automatically deploy to the production environment, same as our original pipeline. It's right. Add workflow code block successfully. We verify three branches. To summarize, in today's video, we learned GitLab CI/CD workflow concept, workflow syntax, workflow first match rule, and how to use workflow in your existing pipeline file. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below. I'll answer. Thank you for watching and see you the next time.